WIHV is the Women's College Hospital Institute for Health System Solutions and Virtual Care. It's a relatively new institute that focuses on developing, implementing, and evaluating new models of care and policy solutions to improve quality and reduce costs in our healthcare system. We're working in close partnership with the Ontario Telemedicine Network to evaluate three digital technologies in patients with chronic kidney disease, diabetes, and mental health.
I've been really fortunate in my journey with Women's College Hospital. All the services have dovetailed off and led one into another. I'm an alcoholic and I'm 10 years in recovery, and I've waited a long time to come to grips with the fact that there's still more work to be done. It was the unresolved trauma that is the underlying challenge in my life. And I attended a first session at Women's College Hospital around the trauma program. And it was an opportunity to access a website called The Big White Wall. And it was there for people dealing with mental health issues.
In the case of mental health, we're evaluating a web-based application that provides structured cognitive behavioral therapy to patients with depression and anxiety and a number of other mental health conditions from the comfort of their own home, and they don't need to go into hospital to be able to access these services.
I think the biggest advantage is the anonymity and the confidentiality. There's a lot of stigma associated with mental health, and the ability to access online systems and to participate in community populations that have similar challenges is incredibly valuable. You can get to talk about your challenges without being able to identify. And in some situations, it's even better than a physical location.
In patients who are by themselves at midnight, if they start to develop depressive tendencies, feelings of anxiety, or even suicidality, this is a resource that's available to them 24/7.
Access to the digital options made it just in time for me.
Telemedicine and digital technology will allow patients in hard to reach parts of the province, mainly by being able to bring care to them. It's going to be able to provide tools that will help patients be able to manage their own care. And so being able to bring care closer to home is not only convenient for patients themselves, but it might provide them care that they otherwise would not have received, particularly if they have a complex chronic disease.
My experience with the web-based applications to support mental health has been really favorable, and I'm really hoping that the research that comes out of it suggests that they should continue to spend money in building that support, because it's the wave of the future.